in hell just as much as there are wicked and vile people. The common denominator is you chose to reject the love of God. You did not want to be saved. You did not want to believe on the Lord Jesus Christ. You did not want to do what God told you to do. You chose to rebel against the Word of God. And in rebelling against God, you think God will weigh out and let you in to a place as much as there's rebellion? Adam and Eve rejected what God told them. He told them, do not eat the fruit. And yet they rebelled against God. They ate the fruit and God drove them out of the garden. If God allows you into heaven with your sins, with rejecting what He said about His Son, God would have to apologize to Adam and Eve. And He will not. When God says, you got to understand, no matter who you think you are, God is not going to apologize. God is not going to change His thoughts because you think you're a good person. For the Bible says there is none good. There is none righteous. No, there is none that seeketh after God. When God says it, that settles it. He will not change. He will never change. The Bible says, I am God, I change not. Isaiah 1. I've got to preach to heavenly just as much as I got to preach to helly. That's a word. You say hell every day. Hello. Why don't you say hell high? Hell high. I can't even say it. Hell high. Hell high. Because you know by your hello, hell is low. When you stop saying hello, I'll stop hell. How about another one? Go to hell. Hell this, hell that. But you get upset when a preacher gets open with the Bible and starts preaching hell. Yeah, it's in the Bible. Jesus spoke more about hell than He did about heaven. And Isaiah chapter 1, we're going to read about God giving you an invitation. God's going to reach out to you. He does not want you to go there. He never designed man to go there. Jesus, God, said, hell was created for Satan and his angels, not man. But because of your rebellion, but because of your sin, I said sin. That's another weird, odd word. Sin. What is sin? Anything that's not right. To him that knoweth to do good and doeth it not, to him it is sin. Sin is when God says no and you say yes. That's sin. Cute little words don't describe sin. Adultery, murder, lying, stealing are sin. Fornication are sins. For all have sinned and come to short of the glory of God. We are all sinners. I'm a sinner. Isaiah 1:18 is that God who loves you. I'm going to read you out of the King James Bible, out of the book of Isaiah. I'm going to read to you God, the Holy God, reaching out to you with an invitation to come. I am going to read to you God reaching out to you and saying, come. God wants to write your name down in the Lamb's book of life today that you may be saved and that when you die, you'll be absent from the body and be present with the Lord. And your name, as whosoever can be written down, as your name in the Lamb's book of life today. You can settle listening. Today you can have your name written down to be with God. But if you choose to reject, if you choose to do your own, if you choose to reject God, your name will never be found in the Lamb's Book of Life. And in Revelation 20, it says that you will be cast into the lake of fire. Into the lake of fire. I didn't say hell. I said the lake of fire. Hell turns in to the lake of fire. And in the lake of fire, you will burn for all eternity. Because you did not settle it. Behold, today is the day of salvation. Today. You may not have tomorrow. But Isaiah 1:18, we reach out to. Come now. That's God reaching out to you. Come now. That's an invitation. It keeps falling. There you go. God is reaching out to you to come now. Right now. He didn't say come later. He didn't say write it down in your appointment book. He didn't say, he said come now. Come. Come and I will open up the Bible. I will show you what you need to do by the Bible to get right with God. I will show you what you need to do out of the Word of God. God says, oh, God would speak to me. Isaiah 1:18, God says, come now. Let us. That is you and God getting together. God says, come and let us. That's you and God, together, as a sinner. God will never throw you out unless you choose to rebel. And yet God says, come now, let us. He's given you an opportunity, as a sinner, to come to Him. And He wants to reason together. God says, come, let us reason. I've got questions about God. I don't know what to do. I don't understand what you're saying. God says, come now, let us reason together out of His Word. Let's get it settled. Let's get you right with God. See, for God so loved the world, He said, come now, let us reason together. I love you. Now come. I love you. Let's get together. I love you. Let's reason. Let that loud-mouthed preacher show you out of my book what needs to be done. For what he speaks out of my word is right. That's an invitation of God. That is the God that said, for God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son. Come now, let us reason together. Though your sins be as scarlet, you've got to come to God as a sinner. God cannot save a righteous person, even though you be self-righteous. I'm saved. I can't be saved again. I'm born again. I can't be reborn again. Or born re-again. Or something. I'm saved. I'm saved. I'm saved. I can't do it again. And God cannot help a self-righteous person that says, forcing you. You got to come to God as a sinner. And people that love and enjoy and make excuses for their sins cannot come to God because of their condition, not God. See, God says, come now, let us reason together. Sins. Come to God with your sins. See, the wages of sin is death. The reason why you're going to die is because you are a sinner. The doctor needs to write on the death certificate. Reason of death, sin, according to the Bible. Now God says, come to me, you sinner. On April 1987, I came to Jesus Christ as a sinner. And I don't need to tell you what those sins were. And you don't need to tell me your sins. You need to tell God. See, you don't go to a priest. You don't go to man with your sins. You go to God with your sins. And you be washed in the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ. See, if I go to a man with my sins, what's the song? Oh, if I go to a man with my sins, he's making a list and checking it twice and get ready to turn you over to the government once. Satan clause is coming. Listen, that's what they did during World War II. Those priests were writing your sins down and turning you over to the government. But when God takes your sins in 1 John 1:9 and you put them under the blood, they are gone, they are washed, they are erased. God, what can't God do? He cannot remember your sins under the blood. Once your sins are washed in the blood of Jesus, in the eyes of God, they are gone. We're not done. Though your sins be as scarlet, they shall be white as snow, washed, clean. Snow, that with pollution is hard, but snow is one of the purest things. Snow is the whitest of white. You know what you are in the eyes of God today? You are red. You are stained. You are sin stained for life. Unless you come to Jesus Christ and be washed in His blood to become white, to become clean. White is a pure, holy, righteous color. And yet, in the eyes of God, if you have not believed in the Lord Jesus Christ, you are stained. A stain you can't get washed. A stain you can't go to man. A stain that no laundromat can do. No washing machine. No detergent. No bleach can cleanse sin like the blood of Jesus can cleanse sin. God says, come now. Let us reason together, you sinner. And I said, April 1987, I was that sinner. Though your sins be as scarlet, you are stained. You are filthy in the eyes of God without the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ. But He said, yet being stained, yet being scarlet. He said that I can make you white as snow. Behold the Lamb of God which take away the sin of the world. Though they be red like crimson, they shall be white. Though they be red as crimson, they shall be as wool. Clean. Wool is natural. Snow is natural. You know what your natural condition is supposed to be? Pure and holy before God. How did you get in a sin condition? You rejected what God told you to do. You say, am I really vile? Am I really that bad? Bad. Have you done what God told you to do? Well, what's God telling me to do? Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ and thou shalt be saved. Have you done that? you are not clean. But I am part of this church. If thou shalt confess thy sin, if thou shalt believe the Lord Jesus Christ, thou shalt be saved. There's no church membership in that verse, Acts 16:31. But I give money. If thou shalt believe the Lord Jesus Christ, thou shalt be saved. There's no money in that verse. But I do, not of works, lest any man should boast. Entrance into heaven is by Jesus Christ and Jesus Christ alone. Well, Peter's going to meet me. You mean the guy that denied him 3 times? That's the guy you want to have the ticket booth in heaven? The one that told Jesus off? The one that called Jesus a liar? That's the one. Oh yeah, that's right. That's just what you are. That's why you want him as judge. Well, Peter will not be judge, because Peter's a sinner just like I am. I'll tell you who'll be the judge in heaven. The holy, the righteous, the sinless perfection of the Lord Jesus Christ will be the judge. And when Jesus Christ tells you to go to hell, that gives out a whole new meaning of the curse. Romans chapter 10. I'm reading from the Bible. I'm giving you the scriptures. Go home and check them out in the King James Bible. Romans 10:9. That if thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus. That's exactly what I'm doing today. I'm confessing the Lord Jesus Christ. And shalt believe in thy heart that God has raised him from the dead. Remember the third part of the gospel? On the third day he arose according to the scriptures. You got to believe in the resurrected Christ to be saved. And my page turn. That God has raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. What must I do to be saved? Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved. The resurrected Christ, the confession of your mouth of Jesus Christ, that in your heart you believe. For with the heart man believes unto righteousness, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation. For the scripture says, whosoever believes on him shall not be ashamed. You know, if you're ashamed of Jesus to speak out and tell people about Jesus, your salvation's in doubt. Because it says, shall not be ashamed. When you believe from the heart, when you confess with the mouth. For there is no difference between the Jew and the Greek. For the same Lord over all is rich unto all that call upon him. Call upon him. Remember I read in Isaiah 1:18? Come now. The invitation of God is to you. Here you are calling out to him. There is no sin that God can't clean. There is no one that God will reject if you come to him as you are. For whosoever shall call... Oh, there's that whosoever again. John 3:16 and Revelation 20. For whosoever. That's the title of today's message. Whosoever. Have you ever gone by an alias? Yes, hey, that preacher man down there in Daytona called me whosoever. For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. Let's do our Acts 16:31 verse. What must I do to be saved? Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ. Thou shalt be saved, whosoever. But Revelation 20 says that if your name is not in the Lamb's Book of Life, yours to whosoever is cast into the lake of fire. Your name has to be named in the book. eyes of God, you are just a whosoever. Before you come to God, you are whosoever. For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. So all you that are whosoever, will you listen to God and come now? I'll turn off the microphone, I'll turn off the camera. Do you want to meet? Come on, don't step out. Who cares what the other whosoever think? It's what will God think. Do you want to be right with God? Do you want to get your eternity settled now? Or is there something missing in your life that the drugs cannot do? The alcohol never finishes. The doctor charges too much. I have no peace. God says, come now. Step out. God is reaching out to you. That's why He has blessed me with a big mouth that you can hear. And I know you can hear. And there may be one person out there right now. Don't be afraid. Fear God. It's the beginning of wisdom. Fearing God and not the people reaching out to say, I want to know what God expects from me. I want to know what God wants me to do. Open that old black book and show me. The invitation's come now. Whosoever. And give opportunity for God to write your name in the Lamb's Book of Life. Don't wait to tomorrow. For too many people this morning, tomorrow never came. And tomorrow never comes. Tomorrow is always tomorrow. What must I do to be saved? Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ. And thou shalt be saved. Saved from what? Going to hell. The wrath of God. The condemnation. Damnation. Being in torments.